My name is Stephanie Sayler, and I'm a research specialist at the University of Michigan School of Public Health in the Department of Environmental Health Sciences. There are about 30,000 abandoned houses in the Detroit area, and it's a problem that's been across the Midwest and the Rust Belt as manufacturing has left. The houses themselves are kind of a risk to public health because they attract crime or rodents, feral dog packs, things along those lines. So the city has started this effort to demolish a lot of these homes. And the problem with that is that a lot of the homes were built in the 20s and the 30s, and so they contain a lot of asbestos and lead and other hazardous materials. We are trying to do a risk assessment to determine the exposures for asbestos that are likely occurring in the community. So when we first get to the site, we want to sample for an hour before they start the demolition in order to determine just the natural levels of asbestos in the area. And then once the demolition begins, we change all the filters out and we recalibrate all of our pumps, and then we sample for approximately 30 minutes during the demolition and then 30 minutes during the cleanup portion. At the end, we are sampling again for another hour in order to see how quickly the asbestos levels return to background. We want to compare houses that have been demolished under different conditions, using different amount of water or whether they've been abated or haven't been abated for asbestos. In the end, we hope to have a recommendation whether or not we recommend that the city continue with the full abatements of all of the properties that they have access to, or it's possible that at the end that we find that there aren't any differences between the community asbestos levels between the abated and not abated homes. I live in the Detroit area and I plan to stay in the Detroit area, so I'm really excited to kind of be a part of the revitalization and the rebuilding of Detroit.